A while ago, I installed a fold-down armrest to my driver's seat in the van, and it's been a bit of a game changer. So I've decided to add one to the passenger seat, but this time film it and show how to install a generic universal armrest to a car or van. Hopefully it's helpful to someone, as when I opened the box, there were no instructions. I began at the back of the van as I needed to move the bed out the way so I could access the back of the front passenger seat. Easy to do, as all my van furniture is completely removable. After a bit of shuffling things around, let me show you what you need to install an armrest, and all this stuff will come in the box when you buy it. You'll get the armrest itself, a mounting point, and a bag of fixings. If you want to get an armrest for yourself, then do check out the links in the description below. They're affiliate links which help support this channel. Most importantly, make sure you've got the correct armrest for the right or left side and the correct mounting point too. I'll go into that a little bit more later. When it comes to my seat, as you can see, I have no zips or obvious access points to remove the fabric seat cover, but there's always a way in. At the bottom of the seat, there's a plastic attachment which you just need to separate, and then there are two clips attached to the metal frame of the seat to remove. With these loose, you can creepily stick your hand through and then push the flap of the fabric from the back of the seat to the front. You can then start rolling up the fabric to expose the foam and frame of the seat. It is a bit tight, but eventually you'll be able to see inside and find the holes we'll be attaching the armrest to. Or, in this case, I made a mistake when filming, and so I'm pointing to the holes you do not attach the armrest to. On the Nissan NV200, it's the lower two holes with the wavy metal attached in between them you want. If you did fit the armrest to the upper holes, you'll be driving with your shoulders up by your ears. We'll be attaching this metal mounting point to these holes, which will require some fixings. Different suppliers include different fixings, but this came with a set of two U-bolts, two standard bolts, one headless hex bolt, six nuts, six bits of wire, and a plastic cap to cover the attachment point. When looking through armrests, you'll need to make sure that the mounting point fits your particular van, which might mean opening up the back of the seat and checking it before buying one. On the Nissan NV200, I use this mounting point on both seats. But first, back to the seat, and you'll see that the fabric cover is physically attached to the chair foam, which means that it will only pull up 6 inches or so. You can pull the foam out from under the seat a little bit, but it only provides limited access, and the more access you have, the better. So I used a ratchet strap to hold the foam and fabric out the way. It was then time to attach the armrest mounting point to the seat, and I used the standard bolts for this. Unfortunately, the holes in the mount were too big for the heads of the bolts to sit flat and securely, so in lieu of having any washers to hand, I screwed on a nut right up to the head of the bolt, and this enabled it to sit flat. Tightening them on using the corresponding nut provided, I grabbed a 12mm hex socket and tightened them up. You can see there's not much space in here, so having that foam pulled up out the way is essential. With the mounting point firmly in place, I could loosely put the armrest on it, and although it looks like it's a different height to the existing armrest, they are in fact level. It's just the camera angle and the fact the driver's seat is further forward. Removing the strap, I could pull the foam back down and then cut a hole in it for the mount to fit through. You don't have to be super neat here, as it'll all be covered by the outer fabric eventually. I could then pull said fabric down and refit it fully. Don't be tempted to cut the hole in the fabric for the mount before the fabric of the seat is completely back in place, otherwise you'll end up with the hole being in the wrong place. Once the fabric was in place and over the mount, I used a sharp blade to cut an X so the metal could poke through. And it was then time to add the armrest. In order for the armrest to be attached, it needs to be sat in exactly the right position, so I used the strap again to pull it further on the mount to where I wanted it to be. With the screw thread on the metal mounting point exposed through the armrest opening, I could screw it in and then tighten it properly with a hex or Allen key. I won't pretend I got it screwed in first time, but it's all about getting the bolt lined up with the right angle for the thread. With that done, I could release the strap and have a fiddle with the adjustability of the armrest. The final part of the install was to add the plastic cap to cover the opening, which, again, is a little fiddly, but once on just finishes the armrest off nicely. Lastly, I could put the van back together and reattach the bed behind the seat. If you're wondering what happened with the other fixings that came in the box, I assume that they're to be used on other vehicles, as I certainly didn't need any of them for this install. After all, it's a universal armrest, suitable for many makes and models. So that's the armrest installed, and all that's left is to raise or lower it to make your driving a little more comfortable. Hopefully it's been a useful guide. Please consider subscribing, and thanks for watching.